Now, ladies and gentlemen, we are celebrating the 75th anniversary of the United Nations. And there is one person symbolizing the United Nations in Serbia. This is Ambassador, no, Madame Ambassador, wait. Simona Miculescu, who is representing the Secretary General of the United Nations in Serbia. Madame Miculescu, the floor is yours.
The rest of the coordinator is Francoise. That's why I was saying that we are more.
I do apologize, no protocol today. Thank you very much. I do apologize.
Thank you. Your Excellency, Deputy Prime Minister and Foreign Minister Ivica Dačić, Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, dobro jutro. Of course, I have first to thank you and thanking the Energy Pact Foundation, the Faculty of Security Studies at the University of Belgrade and the Institute for International Politics and Economics for inviting me, per the recommendation of my dear UN Association of Serbia, to participate in this special session on such an important subject at this moment in our world. What a perfect timing of this conference. Today is the International Peace Day. And today, exactly today, we will have in New York the most important summit high-level meeting on the UN's 75th anniversary. And its theme will be the future we want, the United Nations we need, reaffirming our collective commitment to multilateralism. So I invite you all to watch that, and also the events unfolding this week. It's also a rare pleasure to be able to address you in person, not via one of those virtual platforms that we have been obliged to use and become accustomed with during the COVID-19 pandemic. And actually, this pandemic in itself is demonstrating once again how precious is the value of multilateralism if we are to tackle the greatest human challenges, those which transcend all state and national divisions. In today's world, the quality of multilateral cooperation, whether it be high or low, is a matter of life or death for millions of human beings. Under very different circumstances, the recognition of this essential truth was the impulse behind the United Nations Charter, with Yugoslavia, indeed, once of its signatories and founding members, and the truly multilateral authority that it established for human affairs. Since the founding of the United Nations, the letter and spirit of multilateralism has been under continuous pressure from its obverse, the competitive politics and economics, which have guided most of the recorded human history. Today's forces are clearly often populism, national egoism, resource protectionism, which often win out over solidarity and mutually beneficial cooperation. Perhaps, ironically, this remains the case even at a time when collective challenges are increasing and not decreasing. These include, of course, changes in climate that threaten the quality of life of our children and grandchildren, the freedom of peoples to trade goods and to innovate, the control of disease by advancing medical technology, to name only a few examples. So, leaving aside philosophical questions about what in human beings leads to these constant battles between self-interest and collective interest, we can pose the question, 75 years into this great experiment, how much is the United Nations and the multilateral principles its founders intending holding up? We only have to turn on practically any local, regional, or international news to see security volatility, the prolonging of age-old disputes, and the almost daily generation of new ones, all of which carry high costs to human life and well-being. Soon after the onset of the coronavirus pandemic, UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres appealed to governments, as Minister Dačić mentioned, for the cessation of ongoing violent conflict in order to focus their efforts upon this new worldwide threat. He saw in this crisis an opportunity, an opportunity for promoting unity and aligning thinking, specifically to orient more of our thinking toward the reality of common welfare all across the globe. As another former UN high official, former Undersecretary General Jeffrey Feltman, wrote recently, the UN organization itself remains torn between transition and trepidation. The need for transition in order to improve relations among states and nations, and trepidation, the trepidation that is felt anytime an existing system is faced with the need to make a transition. In an ever more interconnected world, public opinion and media fly in different directions depending on who or what captures the narrative on any given day. While the United Nations should be leading agile responses to these rapidly changing tides, from the inside, I can say this is not always the case, and that is something we believe needs to change, and I'm sure it will be because we are very committed. Many observers of today's world recognize that, in the classical senses, it is neither bipolar, nor unipolar, nor multipolar. It is something different, and it can often appear more chaotic and uncertain than ever. As recognized by our Secretary General, multilateralism must be both globally connected and locally close to the minds of people. It must be inclusive, with the participation of the youngest and the oldest, women and men, businesses and charities, academia and philanthropy, religion and secularism. Serbia and her partners are frequent supporters of multilateralism, not only through active participation in the work of UN multilateral bodies and active contribution to UN peace operations, for which we are always grateful, but also through countless new regional initiatives to promote cooperation. In this, we are all here in this room as sincere partners for a greater cause. I hope that my little introductory remarks help to simulate what I'm sure will be a very high-level conversation on all these issues at this important time, and I'm very excited to take part in it. So thank you again for inviting me here, and let us hope that 75 years on, we can be part of lifting anew the spirit of multilateralism for which the UN foremost stands.
Thank you very much for this presentation, and actually for the open doors, open windows. The old lady 75 years old people now is open to everyone. We spoke about philanthropy, you spoke about philanthropy, academia, new actors, non-governmental actors, and most probably the future of the institution is exactly in that direction. Thank you very much, Miculescu, for this given opportunity.